Hello everyone, Norris here. Welcome back to another FIFA tournament video, and today's team review is gonna be Parma, my favorite team, the team that I'm in love with, man, the team that I do support during the whole time that I start watching football, and just the best team in the world for me. First and all, I mean, talking about Parma in real life, I just want to thank Mr. Kraus, the new president, and his family for all the support that they are giving to Parma. They bought Parma at the beginning of the season. I saw his charisma, his passion, and it's unbelievable. And his promise is that we'll never touch lower divisions again. And I hope that he keeps his words and keeps on making Parma better and better. Now, talking about Parma in FIFA. Last year Parma was good. This year they are a bit better. We did lose Kulusevski, but it's not that he was like a fantastic player in FIFA, because EA did not make him properly. But this year Mr. Kraus and the DC Carly really bought like 7 to 8 beautiful talents. You can see we have seen only Song and Cyprian play in real life. But I'm sure, man, I'm sure that players like Brunetta, Mihaila, or the two defenders, Osorio, and the other defender, the Argentine, are going to be just beast of defenders. 4-3-1-2 is going to be the formation that we will go with this Parma team. This is the default formation that Parma has. This is the formation that Mr. Liverano uses. And I absolutely do agree with him. It's only requiring time in real life to adapt to it, but it's just a tank of formation. And of course in FIFA it's just a beast of formation, man, because you can really play fast and just do damage to your opponents like crazy with this formation. Anyway, in goal is gonna be Sepe. In real life, amazing. In FIFA, not that great, but he still can do incredible saves. Now, I do not agree with EA here. Giving Jacopone and Galliolo better defense than Bruno Alves, that is not, absolutely not correct. But, nothing you can do, is just a game. And, of course, Bruno Alves has to go out, because the center back duo is going to be Jacopone and Galliolo. They do have amazing stats for the rating that they have. Speed, the defense, the physic, it's all there, man. Lauri is going to be the right back. The Argentine player I was talking about, Valenti, sorry bro, I forgot the name for 1 second. Busi, a new addition as well, but he's yet to prove himself. And maybe on January we're going to see a lot of players change ratings and maybe grow more and go to their real potential. So Laurini on the right side, Petzela is going to be on the left side. Last year was Antonino Barilla, even as a midfielder, but I was using him as a left back because of the speed and the physical stats that he has. He just was a proper beast to play on that left back position. Moving on to the midfield, very very important part of your formation, of course, the most important part. And Parma are really like super covered on the midfield position. Cyprian, new addition, Juraj Kučka, he was last year, of course. We got Kurtic, we got Hernani, we got players like Grassi, Brugman, Scott Sarella, different players to use on the position. But Kučka, Juraj Kučka, Kučo, is gonna be your CDM. Take away pace from him, he's a beast on all the different stats. Cyprian, new addition, he's gonna be your left center mid. I know in real life Coach Liverani uses him as a center mid, as a playmaker, but here we're gonna use Kučka because we need those defensive attributes. And Hernani, he's gonna be your right center mid. As I said before, we got different players, man, like Grassi, Brugman, Scott Sorella, to use in that position. Even Som, what a beast he is in real life. I really can't wait to see my guys week to week, to like see incredible performances. But anyway, that is going to be the midfield trio. Kurtic will go out because an incredible player in FIFA for the rating that he has. And I do hope that he is very talented in real life because we haven't seen him yet. Mihaila, he's just incredible in FIFA, man. His stats may not look like that, but for me, the best player on this Parma team to really use in that CAM position. Brunetta, yet to see him, but I'm sure that Coach Liverani will use these two players in that position because those look like beautiful players who can dribble the ball well. And we're gonna play Mihaila there. Gervinho is gonna be your left striker, big boy Gervinho, man. He still got it, he still is doing damage. And in FIFA, he's gonna be just a tank of a player to use. Now, Inglese or Cornelius are both very good in real life, but in FIFA, they are both slow. And this year, I 100% think it's gonna be the year of Yankar Amoah. He has matured a lot, man. His body type has changed a lot. I mean, he is really focused on football as much as I can see that. And he is doing incredible performances. EA has really like need to upgrade his dribbling for sure and his pace. At least 85 dribbling to 85 pace, because that player just deserves it. He's like very, very good player to use. And yeah, this is gonna be the starting 11. We're gonna move on to tactics. It's gonna be balanced with 5, deep is gonna be 3, and at the offensive style is gonna be fast build up with 5 and players in the box 3. I really would suggest Parma to, even in real life, to play more fast build up because we are making like mistakes. Whenever we're trying to hold the ball at the rolls, put whoever you want here. I don't really care, man, as long as you are satisfied. Getting behind, stay forward are gonna be the instructions for both your strikers because they can both run and they can really do damage. Stay forward is gonna be for Mihaila. You want him to be the extra link whenever you're making the beautiful counter attacks, and those three will connect together. Stay back while attacking, stay on the edge of the box and cover center for Juraj Kučka. And you need to change the Cyprian and Hernani to balance crossing and cover center, because on their default they are like crazy, man. They're entering the box for crosses and cover wings, and you just don't want that. You want your formation focused on the center because that is when we're gonna do damage. And stay back while attacking and mixed attack, I mean, because it's an overlap and nothing you can do there because the default formation is 4-3-1-2 for both of your left back and right back. Stay back while attacking and mixed attack. Don't worry, don't forget that, because their default is an overlap. Now we're gonna jump on into two games and you're gonna see how this Parma team performs. First opponent has selected Frankfurt. I really can't wait, man, to see Parma play in Europa League. But anyway, here, a big boy Jervi, beautiful ball roll there, and he will send the ball to the net. Mihaila, he is just fantastic, man. I was really sure that he was gonna be good and very, very good, and he just did not let me down. Look at him and that pace that he has. I mean, look at the class there, beautiful from Mihaila. I hope that some of the Parma guys really will watch this video and maybe they can give their opinion. Gervinho here to Willy Cyprian, beautiful here again, beautiful easy football there, and it's gonna make it 4-0. Here I will give up a penalty kick and my opponent will score. Beautiful penalty kick there, I mean, took me to the other side, and it's gonna be 4-1. Here you can see Jacopone, what an interception is that, to Juraj Kučka, to Hernani, to Gervinho, to Caramoa, sorry, to big boy Jervi, and he will never miss from there, and he's gonna make it 5-1. This is gonna be just a parade of goals, to be fair to you, with this Frankfurt team. Here you can see Mihaila again, to big boy Jan Caramoa. He is doing a fantastic passing to Gervinho, keeping it simple, and just make it 6-2 there, beautiful. I mean, that is just a goal just for fun, to be fair. My opponent will score here back, it's gonna be 6-3, but I'm not done yet. Beautiful there to William Cyprian, he can run with the ball fantastically, beautiful ball roll there, Again, just keep it simple, passing to one another, and it's gonna make it 7-3. Koromoa again, I mean, if the stats would be real, that defender would just not have a chance, man, to really be close to him, but that is just beautiful. Again, passing it, simple passes, easy top-ins there, and it's gonna make it 8-3. You can see Big Boy Jervy here, 5 attempts, 5 goals. I mean, what more can you ask from your striker? You can jump on to another game now, and Parma is going to be against Celtics. This really is like a legendary clash, to be fair, because on in their days, these two teams just were incredible. I did offer my opponent to leave this game because you just could not see anything, but luckily I can recognize my players, and I mean, I could really see whenever my players was, but this just was unplayable. You can see Gervinho here running and running and running. I see Mihaila there, that is beautiful with his weak foot, which is a 4-star weak foot, but he can really, the kid can do damage, man. I'm telling you, we have not seen him in real life play yet, but he's just gonna be a beast of a player, and he's gonna make it 3-1 again. Giancaramoa to Mihaila, beautiful to Gervinho, ball roll, simple, getting past the goalkeeper, he's gonna make it 4-1. Big Boy Jervy always posts about FIFA. I hope that he posts something like my video too on his Instagram. It's gonna be just amazing, man, to see that here. Maybe it's just a glitch in the game. Maybe Pepe did let me down, but nah, he didn't. I love him. But yeah, just 4-3 here. Mihaila to Hernani, beautiful Brazilian skill there. And he's gonna make it 5-3. So this is gonna be pretty much it at the end of this video. Mihaila there, man of the match. I hope you guys did enjoy it. If you did, please leave a like and subscribe to the channel, because it does help a lot. Again, thank you guys for watching. Forza Parma, and I'll see you again. Bye.